Okay, so we're recording speckle images of two of the moons. We'll find out which ones they are. Don't know which ones they are. But I might actually be able to do some speckle imaging on these. That would be very, very cool. I haven't done speckle interferometry in quite a while, so it'd be kind of interesting if I can get away with that. So hope you're enjoying this a little bit. Just looking at Jupiter at opposition by request, and it was a good observing session tonight. I think I got some decent data. The telescope was pointing, either the telescope was pointing relatively okay, or I was just unusually lucky. I think it was maybe a combination of both. So there's two of the moons of Jupiter. Don't know which ones they are. I will find out. I will put them in the, probably in the title. If not in the title, I'll put them in the description, which ones those two are. I'll probably do about 3 minutes of this, and then probably call it a night. Call it a successful night. I'm hoping that these little moons aren't overexposed. If they are overexposed and I really can't do any kind of speckle imaging on them at all, but if there's any chance of not being overexposed, then I'll be able to do some high resolution imaging. Now, this camera is definitely not suitable for extremely high-res imaging, but I should be able to get them at least down to a pixel. Maybe I'll be able to do some photometry on them, look at their relative brightnesses. It'll kind of be cool. And yeah, the tracking is pretty good here. It's a much wider field of view than my CCD camera, though. I think, is it or isn't it? No, because this is like 44 arc seconds across here, if I remember right. So actually, this is higher res than my camera, my CCD camera. So I don't know. I'll have to think about that.